400 पार अब की बार।
तीसरी सबसे बड़ी इकोनॉमी के लिए, गरीब की उन्नति के लिए, किसान कल्याण के लिए, युवाओं को नए अवसर के लिए, महिला सशक्तिकरण के लिए, मजबूत भारत के लिए, आत्मनिर्भर भारत के लिए, समृद्ध भारत के लिए।
Narendra Modi had fixed a big aim of 400 par this election. But when the results came in on the 4th of June, the NDA had less than 300 seats. For the first time in a decade, the BJP doesn't have absolute majority and Narendra Modi has to run a coalition government.
It has not been quite up ki bar 400 par for the NDA in the 2024 general elections. The NDA has finished at 290 odd seats and the BJP has got 240 seats in these elections. It has stopped short of a majority mark of 272, but the BJP says that it is only after 1961 and over six decades that a Prime Minister has won a third consecutive term and Mr. Narendra Modi is going to be the Prime Minister again after Jawaharlal Nehru could do this for three terms way back in the 1960s. Mr. Nehru did not have any big opposition against him in those three terms, but Mr. Modi has fought against the Congress and almost the entire regional parties against him in an opposition alliance this time. The BJP is also saying that its vote share has remained almost intact and it has swept various states like Madhya Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh and won a majority of seats in states like Chhattisgarh and Gujarat as well. The BJP is saying that can very well run a strong coalition government while the Congress is calling this a moral defeat of the BJP. The BJP says the Congress, which has failed to cross the 99 mark even after a decade, has in fact much to answer on its own poor performance.
इस जनादेश के कई पहलू हैं। 1962 के बाद पहली बार कोई सरकार अपने दो कार्यकाल पूरे करने के बाद तीसरी बार वापस आई है।
इट इज द रिटर्न of coalition politics to Indian democracy, and the parliament proceedings in the coming days could be a hotly contested affair. The BJP is dependent on two key allies, Chandra Babu Naidu and Nitish Kumar, to maintain a majority in the Lok Sabha. Chandra Babu Naidu and Nitish Kumar, who lead the TDP and the JDU, have left the NDA in the past after being dissatisfied over certain issues. They were also the last entrants into the NDA just few months before the elections, and now Chandra Babu Naidu is a key constituent with 16 seats and Mr. Nitish Kumar is the third biggest constituent in the NDA with 12 seats. Are these allies trustworthy? Because Nitish Kumar is known to do political somersaults in the past, while Mr. Chandra Naidu had left the NDA on the account of the special status for Andhra Pradesh.
10 साल से ये प्रधानमंत्री हैं और फिर प्रधानमंत्री होने जा रहे हैं और इन्होंने पूरे देश की सेवा की। अब पूरा भरोसा है कि जो कुछ भी बचा है अगली बार ये सब पूरा कर देंगे और जो भी हर राज्य का है, और हम लोग पूरे तौर पर सब दिन इनके साथ रहेंगे और पूरे तौर पर जो कुछ भी है आज जिस तरह से भी ये करेंगे बहुत अच्छा है। और आप जान लीजिए कि कुछ लोग हम लोगों को तो अब लगता है कि अगली बार जो आप आइएगा ना, तो इस बार हम देखें कि कुछ इधर उधर कुछ जीत गया है, अगली बार सब हारेगा, हमको पूरा भरोसा है।
टुडे इंडिया इज हैविंग राइट लीडर राइट टाइम, दैट इज नरेंद्र मोदी। This is a very good opportunity for India. If we miss now, we will miss forever. Now, I proudly propose the name of Sri Narendra Modi ji on behalf of Telugu Desam Party for the post of Prime Minister of this great nation.
As he returns for a historic third term in power, Modi is facing a very different political reality from the one that he has been used to. Even when he was the Chief Minister of Gujarat, he never had to rely on allies.
आज मैं कह सकता हूं कि भारत के राजनीतिक व्यवस्था में एक ऑर्गेनिक अलायंस है. और ये मूल्य श्रद्धेय अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी, श्री प्रकाश सिंह जी बादल, श्री बाला साहब ठाकरे, श्री जॉर्ज फर्नाडी, श्री शरद यादव, अनगिनत नाम में कह सकता हूं, इन लोगों ने जिस बीज को बोया था वो आज भारत की जनता ने विश्वास का सिंचन कर करके उस बीज को वट वृक्ष बना दिया है.
While the NDA looks ahead, the BJP is still smarting from the results of the 2024 Lok Sabha elections. The party lost nearly 60 seats from its 2019 tally of 303. Where did the BJP go wrong? The debacle in Uttar Pradesh and Samajwadi Party's resurgence is the biggest factor.
वैसे तो अलग-अलग जगह अलग-अलग कारण हैं, लेकिन जो सबसे ज्यादा हमको जिसने नुकसान पहुंचाया, पहले से ही लोगों को ये लगने लगा था कि हम तो जीत गए. इस आत्मविश्वास ने हमको इस स्थिति में लाकर खड़ा कर दिया.
मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है कि फतेहपुर में जो काम हमने शुरुआत की थी उसमें कहीं ना कहीं विराम जरूर लगा. काम की दृष्टि से फतेहपुर में जो हुआ है मुझे लग रहा है कि उसमें कहीं ना कहीं ब्रेक लगा. उम्मीद करती हूँ जो चुनाव जीते हैं इस काम को आगे बढ़ाएं.
500 साल के कलंक को हमने मिटाया है. लॉ एंड ऑर्डर हमारा बढ़िया रहा है. विकास जो 65 साल में नहीं 70 साल में हुआ है. और मोदी जी ने बीच के दलालों की दलाली को खत्म किया है. ऐसा किसी गांव में एक व्यक्ति नहीं होगा जो लाभार्थी न हो. कुछ न कुछ लाभ सबको मिला है. उसके बावजूद भी माननीय मोदी जी को पूरा आशीर्वाद न मिलना ये समीक्षा का विषय है, पार्टी समीक्षा का विषय.
The biggest losses for the NDA, which is of 70 seats, have come in the four states of Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and Haryana. Uttar Pradesh, where the NDA had won 66 seats, NDA is down to 36 seats, a massive loss of 30 seats in UP. In Maharashtra, where the NDA had won 41 seats, it is now down to just 17 seats, a massive loss in Maharashtra as well. The other big state where the BJP has lost the big time, had swept all 25 seats in Rajasthan last time. It is down to 14 seats this time, a loss of 11 seats. And also in the state of Haryana, where the honors have been split, where BJP has now won only 5 out of the 10 seats after sweeping Haryana continuously in the last term as well. Why did these losses occur in the states of Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Rajasthan and Haryana is something that the BJP will have to closely introspect. But in UP, it seems a caste consolidation of Dalits, non-Yadav OBCs and Muslims has worked against the BJP in a state where the BJP is very, very powerful with the chief minister for the last two terms in Mr. Yogi Adityanath. In Rajasthan, it seems the belt where Sachin Pilot is strong, Eastern Rajasthan and Shekhawati is where the Congress has made its biggest gains. In Haryana, it is Mr. Bhupinder Hooda and Dipinder Hooda's belt where the BJP has lost 5 seats. And with Haryana elections coming up in a few months, these are alarm bells for the BJP. These are the states where the BJP will need to focus upon in the days to come.
लोकतंत्र के लिए बहुत आवश्यक है कि एक बहुत ही मजबूत विपक्ष हो, बहुत ही सजग विपक्ष हो और सरकार को तलवार की नोक पर चलने के लिए मजबूर करे, ऐसा विपक्ष होना ही चाहिए.
But it wasn't all bad news. In Odisha, the BJP ousted the ruling BJD and ended the 24-year run of Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik. The BJP also finally opened its account in Kerala and doubled its tally in Telangana.
You've won the seat for BJP, first time in the history of Kerala. How does it feel?
I won the seat for the people of Kerala, not just Trichur. And it is adding luster to the growth of my party, which gets an extension and intrusion into Kerala, which was almost like all the politically incorrect thinking segment of Kerala thought, decided, started propagating. So it's a big question mark now.
Do you think that this is the first of many that is going to come for BJP?
Definitely, definitely. We will grow from here.
As Mr. Narendra Modi begins his historic third term as the Prime Minister of the country, this particular term also comes with a host of new challenges. The BJP under Mr. Modi would want to push ahead on its ambitious agenda of the Uniform Civil Code and a One Nation, One Election, but could face some spirited opposition from the other benches in the parliament, which are dead against both these moves. Also, as the challenge in the key states of Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh and Haryana, because Maharashtra and Haryana are states which go to elections just a few months later, and BJP faces challenge of holding on to these two states, especially after the reverses it has seen in both these states in the Lok Sabha elections. Uttar Pradesh is another key state where the BJP would be very, very keen to hold on to power after 2 years when the state goes to elections, and the setback it has seen in Uttar Pradesh will be undergo a serious introspection and maybe a caste realignment. Reaching out to the OBCs, reaching out to its core vote base in UP will be top on the BJP's agenda. BJP, however, still feels that Mr. Narendra Modi is a leader with high popularity in the country, a cult status, and there is nobody quite near the popularity and the appeal of Mr. Narendra Modi in the country right now. The party is banking on Mr. Modi to pull it out of this mini crisis of sorts and lead a strong government in the next 5 years and settle those doubts which are there in the opposition camp that Mr. Modi cannot run a coalition government. On the other side of this break, we'll look at what worked for the opposition alliance and the Congress party and why are they rejoicing even though the Congress has only touched 99 seats.
The Lok Sabha election results gave a new lease of life to the INDIA bloc. Dismissed as an unlikely front which would break up soon, these unnatural allies managed to stick together till the end and force Narendra Modi to head a coalition government.
The country has unanimously and clearly stated, we do not want Mr. Narendra Modi and Mr. Amit Shah to be involved in the running of this country.
When the alliance was first formed, there appeared to be more misses than hits. The TMC didn't want an alliance with the Congress in Bengal. AAP and Congress joined forces in Delhi, but fought each other in Punjab. Despite these contradictions, the INDIA bloc persevered. Concentration on their own turf ensured a good performance for each of the stakeholders. The Congress's narrative of saving democracy and the constitution and pitching for reservation and a caste census all worked. The party had its best tally since 2014.
Congress party aur hamare India gathbandhan se bahut pratikul mahol mein chunav lada. Sarkari machinery ne kadam kadam par avrodh dala. Bank khate seize karne se lekar tamam netaon ke khilaf abhiyan chalaya. Phir bhi shuru se आखिर तक कांग्रेस पार्टी का कैंपेन सकारात्मक था, पॉजिटिव था. हमने महंगाई, बेरोजगारी, किसानों और मजदूरों की बदहाली और संविधान संस्थाओं का दुरुपयोग जैसे विषयों को केंद्रीय मुद्दा बनाकर हम जनता के सामने गए थे. इन मुद्दों पर बड़ी संख्या में लोग हमसे जुड़े, हमारा समर्थन किया। प्रधानमंत्री ने जिस तरह का कैंपेन किया वो इतिहास में लंबे समय तक याद रखा जाएगा। कांग्रेस के घोषणा पत्र के बारे में मोदी जी ने जो झूठ फैलाया जनता ने उसे समझ लिया।
The biggest success story for the INDIA block came from the biggest state of Uttar Pradesh. A state which was seen as a BJP bastion where they built a grand Ram Mandir. But the Modi Yogi juggernaut couldn't stop the Samajwadi Party storm.
Akhilesh ji, what is the reason of this magic that Samajwadi Party has done in the state of Uttar Pradesh?
Dekhiye, main desh ki aur Bharat ki और खासकर उत्तर प्रदेश की जनता का धन्यवाद और आभार प्रकट करूंगा कि उन्होंने नई आस के साथ, नई उम्मीद के साथ और सकारात्मक राजनीति का समर्थन किया है। सौहार्द की राजनीति हो, नकारात्मक लोगों से दूरी हो, इस लोकतंत्र का सबसे बड़ा संदेश है यही कि जनता ने, खासकर उत्तर प्रदेश की जनता ने लोकतंत्र को बचाने के लिए, संविधान को बचाने के लिए और आरक्षण को बचाने के लिए वोट दिया है। जो पीडीए परिवार इंडिया गठबंधन की रणनीति बना उसका परिणाम यह है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी उत्तर प्रदेश में हार गई।
मुलायम सिंह यादव जी के बाद ये पहला चुनाव है अखिलेश जी, जब समाजवादी पार्टी को इतनी बड़ी जीत मिली, कैसे देखते हैं?
नेताजी ने जो रास्ता दिखाया तो उसी रास्ते पे चल रहे हैं और हमें उम्मीद है कि इसी रास्ते पे चल करके जो सांप्रदायिक ताकतें हैं जिन्होंने समाज को बांटने का काम किया या बाबा साहब भीमराव अम्बेडकर जी का संविधान को ठेस पहुंचाने की कोशिश की, उनको हराने का काम लगातार।
One of the biggest upsets was Smriti Irani losing Amethi to Gandhi loyalist Kishori Lal Sharma. In 2019, it was Irani who was the giant slayer when she defeated three-time Amethi MP Rahul Gandhi. This time, Congress decided to field a non-Gandhi against Irani. The odds were against Sharma, the former campaign manager of Sonia Gandhi in Rai Bareli. But he prevailed and his win was also a victory for the Gandhis.
इतनी बड़ी जीत स्मृति ईरानी को अमेठी से आपने हराया। भाजपा हमेशा से कहती रही है कि वहाँ चाहे राहुल गांधी लड़े चाहे आप लड़े, जीत बीजेपी की होनी है, लेकिन आपको कितना बड़ा श्रेय आप किसको देना चाहेंगे इस जीत के लिए और क्या लगता है कि क्या चीज़ें काम करी आपके लिए वहाँ?
देखो, वहाँ पे हमारी जनता ने हमारा साथ दिया और गांधी परिवार की ताकत ने मेरे को जिताया है, ठीक है। बाकी अगर वो बीजेपी ऐसी बात कर रही है तो मेरे को लगता है कि वो शायद सरकारी मशीनरी से जीतना चाहते होंगे, ठीक है, लेकिन जनता ने माना नहीं किसी को।
Another big surprise was SP winning the Faizabad seat, which houses the Ram Mandir in Ayodhya, 4 months after the consecration ceremony of the temple, which the BJP took credit for.
Ayodhya mein jo
the SP leader who snatched the seat from the BJP is veteran MLA Avadesh Prasad, who was the only candidate from a Dalit community to win from a non-reserved constituency.
जिस भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने अयोध्या के लिए इतने विकास कार्य किए, सड़कें बनवाई और सब किया, जिसे कहते हैं डेवलपमेंट की एक लहर चली, रेलवे स्टेशन बना, एयरपोर्ट बना, तमाम बातें भारतीय जनता पार्टी करती आ रही है। स्वयं योगी आदित्यनाथ हर महीने अयोध्या में रहते थे विकास कार्य का जायजा लेने के लिए। ऐसे में अवधेश प्रसाद एक ऐसी फोर्स बन के आए कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी को चित्त कर दिया अयोध्या में।
ऐसा है कि 22 जनवरी को प्राण प्रतिष्ठा हुई और देश के तमाम लोग आए और करोड़ों अरबों लोग जनता की गाड़ी कमाई खर्च की गई। देश से भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने तमाम फ्री गाड़ियां किया, सरकारी बसें किया और लाखों लाख लोगों को अयोध्या में पहुंचाने का काम किया। ये केवल उनका दृष्टिकोण, उनका मंशा, केवल चुनाव को दृष्टिगत रखते हुए सब काम किया गया।
In Bengal, Mamata Banerjee fought hard to ensure that BJP couldn't make the gains like it had in 2019.
Modi ji single largest majority payni, oni credibility lost korechen, onar immediate pradhanmantri theke resignation deya uchit, karon uni bolechilen isbar 400 par, ami bolechilam pogar par, ekhon take pay dhorte hocche TDP ar pay dhorte hocche Nitish.
The INDIA also made a stunning comeback in Maharashtra despite a splintered NCP and Shiv Sena. The DMK Congress combined also swept the state of Tamil Nadu despite an aggressive campaign by the BJP. Even Rajasthan, Karnataka, Haryana and Punjab are stories of the right strategy for the INDIA bloc. They may not be forming the government, but that hasn't stopped them from celebrating.
The India Front has found a voice and the Congress has become even more aggressive and also found its mojo. Just a few months back, everyone had written off the alliance as a coming together of unlikely partners. But now they have big plans. Of course, they've decided not to form the government and not even make preparations for that. But they are not going to let it be easy for the BJP either. As far as the India Front is concerned, they think that a Prime Minister doesn't have a mandate to take oath for the third term. And every step ahead, that's exactly the kind of strategy that they are going to be adopting. And of course, the big challenges ahead is winning the state elections.